So beautiful.
No autographs.
No autographs.
No autographs yet, right? No autographs.
I made those. It's ham, very lean ham, Munster cheese, whole wheat, real butter with some.
So it'd be easier to take the picture, and then you've got that real high res.
I mean, it's solid. I didn't even think about that before I went to get that scan.
That's a detail, man.
That's good for our Facebook page right now.
Oh, that's perfect. And then we'll get a lot of comments.
If we do prints and cups and stuff like that, I'll do a better image and make it real crisp. Mm-hmm. That's just to get it up quick, because I thought it was cool. I mean, I got it back, you know, you gotta get antsy and you want to, you know, get something up like that.
Oh, but that, to me, did you show Hans that?
Yeah, it won't show up on this camera, though.
Oh, that's all right.
It's like bright backlit.
But that, to me, is just incredible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I tell you, what a team we have here, folks. Yep. And he took some of my hair away. you know, the worst part about this show, folks, is they powder my head before we go on the air.
That was cheaper, $300.
But you know what? That's okay. If I had a lot of hair, I wouldn't be this handsome, right, guys?
That's right.
It just gets
y'all can speak up and say yes, maybe, to a question.
Yes.
Thank you. That wasn't a real quick response.
Well, it'd be less aerodynamic. I mean, it just...
You couldn't run as fast if you had too much hair. Plus, you don't have to wash it and style it and dye it and cut it.
Cool segment. I saw this thing the other day where they're making these new running shoes.
Yeah.
And they take a mold of your feet, and then they actually have a 3D printer print your shoes. And then it fits you literally perfectly. And it shaves like 0.01 seconds off of a 40-yard. Yeah.
Well, that would be worthwhile to get a $600 pair of shoes for that for me, because I've been trying to keep my numbers down.
Well, you know, when I went out for the Redskins last year,
if you only ran 0.1 seconds less,
maybe it'd be better for criminals.
Yeah, there you go.
Criminals, there. I always bring up a good element, Robin. Yeah. I don't know how he does that.
So Hans just showed me how to use this camera.
Uh-huh.
And, look at that. Oh,
yeah, that's a good idea.
We're tilting. Here we go. He's all right.
Too much coffee.
Yeah. Well, this is kind of cool here.
I meant to make a DVD, but I think I just got so wrapped up in everything today. And the reason why I was late because I had to pick up my truck at 5:30 to get, because I had to have oxygen sensors put in it or something. Mm-hmm.
You didn't run out of oxygen, did you? Okay. Well, thank you, Hans. I'll learn how all this
we're
works.
We're gonna have to sit on your PS3 and.
So what we're looking for is the actual script, uh-huh. Which no one brought today.
It's at my office.
It's at your office, but I sent it in your email.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And if it's in your email, then if you don't
I have all of the stuff categorized from the show.
Okay, so I wrote the script, and then we revised it to cut out that conversation, and that's the one I took to the actual film shoot.
Right.
So here we are looking
Welcome.
For the script.
You got mail.
Because I, who wrote the script, didn't bring the right script today. So there's obstacle number one.
I have it on my other computer, so we'll do it this way.
Trying to open the document of the script, and for some reason it won't read it. It wants a file conversion, so we have to... Yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
That's
not even close.
Not even close. All right, so we'll have to come up with something else.
We'll make it work.
We'll make it work.
I'm just trying to... what we did is we basically went back and forth and talked about... don't you wish... Remember he said, don't you wish we could watch this and you're way over there and I'm over here?
Yeah.
We can do that. We can ad-lib that.
So we're going to try to open the script.
This is the script.
Okay. But you can't read it when he opens it.
All right. So this is a docx file.
Okay. Are we shooting this?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So here's what's going on here. Okay. So we have a Microsoft Word file that was written in a different version of Microsoft Word than the one that you have installed.
And I can't open it.
Right. So we've got a Microsoft Word 2003 software installation here. All right. And I'm betting that the document itself is probably written in Microsoft 2010 or 2007, something like that.
Yeah, okay. it's Hans.
Yeah, it's got Vista.
Okay, all right, so what we're going to do here, by default, Word wants to try to just open and figure out what kind of document it is, but since it can't figure it out, when we open it up, it's going to look like a bunch of gobbledygook, like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know if I can read that with this camera.
Yeah.
But it's a gobbledygook.
It looks like Japanese to me.
It's very Japanese. Yeah.
So what we're going to do is we're going to close that out. Mm-hmm.
Now, one thing we could try is we can right-click and see if it says open with, mm-hmm. and it comes with a couple different options there. We can try opening it up with WordPad, and you can see it works.
That looks like German.
Yeah, still not going to work. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to...
You're going to try to find something. I'm going to guess he's going to try to find something he's going to try to find something on the internet that will open it. Am I right?
Pretty much. Mm-hmm. Huh? Look at that. Now, because I already know we've got something on the internet that will open it, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to log into my Gmail account. And I'm going to use Google Docs.
G is for geek.
Geek mail. Yep. All right. So I'm going to log in. And
okay.
Actually, you know what? Hold on a second. Let me log into my Stuart at Dean the Geek and see if I can remember the password. Actually, no. I'll use my personal Gmail account here.
Okay.
And let's see here. Now it's not going to let me log in until it sends me a text message.
I guess that's for security.
For security, that's right. And so what's going to happen is Google has recognized that I'm logging in from a computer that I don't usually use. And in order to let me log in here, what it's going to do is it's going to send me a text message, and it's going to tell me what my verification code is. So if I open up my text.
Pretty impressive so far.
Yeah.
I heard some noise.
There you go. So 565-836.
565-836.
What's that for?
Now, that's my verification code.
Okay.
It only works one time, so...
So nobody can steal that?
That's right.
So it changes the next time.
Exactly.
Cool.
So I'll go ahead and log in here. And as soon as it comes up, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my Google Drive. Oh, hold on a second. Yep, good. Okay. All right, so now I'm logged into my...
Gunfighter.
My Gmail account. And I'm going to go to my Google Drive. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to click the upload button here, all right? And I'm going to tell it I want to upload files. And then I'm going to go into DEET, documents.
I can't see that.
And where are we at here?
You're looking for DEET and the Geek.
I can't see it.
DEET and the, there we go, DEET and the Geek. And
there is the script we're looking for.
All right, so it's going to upload, and it's uploaded. So now we can click on it.
Any luck?
He's getting there.
There it goes.
See how that?
Did it work?
He taped it.
Is that now we have to see if it's the right one?
Yep. Yeah. Let's see here.
It should have.
How do you do it?
He had to go through.
It would say cut to detail somewhere.
He had to go to another thing. Had to bring the internet in. Two very intelligent people right here.
Yeah. Thank you.
This one starts fade in, standing in a wrestling ring.
I think that's it.
Warrior.
We got it.
Yeah.
Okay. We got it. That's
right. So we want to print this out?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. See, we have
a couple of them. Yeah.
Couple of them. Okay.
See that? We overcame that obstacle.
And that's because we have a geek. A geek in the group.
Yeah, right. A group geek.
And
he's a geek grouper.
I've got two copies.
He's a geek. Is he a geek grouper?
He's a
groupable geek.
Groupable
geeky.
Geeky, geeky, geek. Okay, cool deal.
And there we go. We are now printing.
And that's printing.
And right here, ladies and gentlemen, we have, and you may be lucky enough one day to receive one of these, a note from us. With our own cards of Deet and the Geek.
Oh, look at that.
Maybe inviting you to be on our show.
That's right.
What do you think of that?
We'll have to hold a contest.
That's right. And we will be having guests on the show.
Cool.
I love you guys out there. I really do. Isn't he good?